current CBC. My next guest studies how communities can heal after tragedy. Michael Ungar is the Canada Research Chair in Child, Family, and Community Resilience at Dalhousie University. Michael, good morning to you.
Good morning, Matt.
You heard what Tiffany Ward is doing and what people in her community are doing to pull together in what is a really difficult time, amplified by the fact that we're in this global pandemic. What has struck you the most about the way that people are grieving at this time?
Well, first of all, I never thought as someone who researches resilience in communities all over the world that I'd actually be sort of bringing this research right back into my backyard.
Yeah.
But it's quite remarkable the way we're adapting. And what Tiffany said is just beautiful, how we're trying to find alternative ways during the pandemic to wrap our arms around our communities. When you look at communities that are resilient, you often see a couple of things. One is they're looking for resources that will actually sustain them during a crisis, but those resources have to be given to them, or they have to find them in ways that are meaningful, or that they can negotiate so that they can get them in ways that make sense to them. And that is actually what's so innovative, perhaps, about this, is that we're thinking about how we can have these virtual vigils where we're literally doing whatever we can to, well, reclaim public space, which is actually a big part of what communities do to be resilient, which is why you see them always, you know, people standing shoulder to shoulder with the candles. We do these things to assert ourselves back into those public spaces as a way of reclaiming our sense of safety as well.
You've seen people who are painting their windows, and we've been hearing this, singing songs, they're tying tartans around the front porch. How do those sorts of gestures help with that healing?
Well, I think what they're doing is they're establishing the sense of cohesion. We know from lots of other communities that have been under stress of all sorts, including violence related to mass shootings or loss of industries, closing down, violence, whatever, that what you'll see over and over is these patterns of people signaling to each other that we are connected. And in a sense, Matt, rejecting that identity being thrust on us by the violence. I mean, people here in Nova Scotia, I know we don't see ourselves as how this makes the community look, in a sense. This is not our identity, and this is not the way the world perceives Nova Scotia. So, you know, when I'm walking down, you know, doing my daily walk, and I'm seeing tartans flying from people's, out at the front of people's driveways and this type of thing, what it's signaling to me is this kind of assertion that, you know, this is who we are. We are better than this, and we are not going to let this define us as a province or as a community. And it's quite powerful to watch.
You study resilience and resilience in children as well. And when the Prime Minister spoke earlier this week, he spoke directly to children. We know that kids are affected in this in ways that perhaps we may not see initially, but that they're still feeling, the anxiety that we're all kind of manifesting right now. How do you comfort children in the midst of something like this?
Well, what we've seen from, again, other kinds of tragedies is we want to make sure that children get the information they need to process this in age-appropriate ways. But hiding children from this is probably not the solution. You know, in lighter times, I might have reminded people that fairy tales used to be full of blood and gore, and, you know, Cinderella's sisters had their toes chopped off to fit into the slipper. And, I mean, children think the most horrific things. They know something is happening. They're not, you know, they're going to be picking it up just in the air, if you will. They're going to sense that things are going wrong. And the more we can sort of share with children that something bad has happened, but then reassure them that they are safe, that the police did what they needed to do, and then to take the children back out into any kind of public space that you can. I mean, of course, that's going to just be your driveway, the front of your house, or a walk around the block. But bringing children back into those spaces is going to show them more than your words that things have stabilized. And children, by the way, and we adults too, respond to getting back into routines. I love the fact that Tiffany said just at the beginning of her interview, you know, how's today? Well, today is just going to be a bit like yesterday. We're going to get on. We're going to fall back into those structures and those patterns. And those, for children especially, they signal, hey, yesterday was okay, today will be okay. And the more we can make the world predictable for a kid, the more likely that child is to sort of move through this and feel like the future is still there for them, and maybe fight back depression and anxiety a little bit.
Just in the last minute or so, what is it that gives you hope when it comes to resiliency in your province? This has been a really hard week for people in Nova Scotia. Yeah.
Well, what gives me hope and what I've learned from other places around the world, too, is that resilience doesn't begin now. It began years and years ago in these communities as they swapped casseroles down the street, as people, you know, needed help, as they got to know each other. These are the foundation stones for resilience. And because a lot of these small communities, they have that social cohesion, they have a sense of belonging, they have a sense of place, they can come back much stronger because, you know, we know that I'm imagining what's going to happen is people are going to revisit the very values that have always been strong there. Maybe not this week. This week is for grieving and probably a lot of very, you know, dark feelings. But over time, very shortly, those values will reawaken and hopefully people will anchor back to those and those will be what is being celebrated.
Michael, good to speak with you. Thank you.
Take care.
Michael Ungar is the Canada Research Chair in Child, Family, and Community Resilience at Dalhousie University. We reached him in Halifax.